Hi, I'm Josh, and welcome back to Skyrim. Now, first off, look at how cool this light falls upon my shoulders and my face. I love it. I am dead tired. I've been walking around the city for hours. I've been doing stuff, like buying stuff and appointments and stuff. But, I've also come to a certain conclusion when it comes to Skyrim. You know how I said what we're gonna do Serana's thing right now? We're not. At the end of this particular quest line, we are going to have to become vampires. And I do not want to become a vampire yet. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure we have the enhanced dwarven crossbow available before we turn vampire. Why would I do that? Well, because if I'm a vampire, I can't really work for the Dawnguard, now can I? So, for the entire time that I'm a vampire, at least for the first little while, the Dawnguard quest is going to be standing still, which is fine by me. The most important thing for me is for me to become a vampire, so that I can get the XP boost perk from sleeping, and perhaps sleeping with a wife, yes. As well, there's the matter of there's also the matter of... Hell, what was I saying? Yeah, I want to re-level my smithing and my and my alchemy. For that, I would also like the Ethereum Crown. You know what the Ethereum Crown is? Now, the Ethereum Crown is a one of the Ethereum items you can smith once you're done with the Ethereum quest. I'm not going to go into too much details, but I want the Ethereum Crown, and I want a wife, which means access to Riften. Before I can really get started on getting back to my full potential when it comes to magic and stuff. And that's about it. Right. Key to Robber's Cove, perfect. Yeah, you go fight the dragon, I'll fight you. So much for truces. Just some gold and some arrows, I guess. Yeah, there's a few more bandits near here. And a dragon, apparently. Which Serana and the Ice Troll seem to be dealing with.
Think you could take me?
Maybe. Oh, there's another dragon over there. That's weird.
Oh no, you don't.
Ah, blood dragon's taking a lot of damage from what if I can actually fight this dragon with fire? Oh, my destruction magic certainly likes it. And I never have to worry about projectiles because these guys are just going to go in a straight line. I mean, I need to leave my target a bit better. Are you prey? Is he dead? I think he is. Again, Serana can't die, and my troll could just be replaced. Yep, he's dead as a doornail. And I can still walk. Yay! Thank heaven for small victories. Oh, this dragon must have gotten up from this. Interesting. Well, Alduin's been here recently. oh yeah, Alduin. We still need to... So many things happening at once. But yeah, I've got a pretty clear plan as to what I want to do. I want to make sure I have plans for the enhanced dwarven crossbow, as well as all the bolts. And then I want to... Wait a minute. So all the bolts. And then I want to... probably get a wife and get the Ethereum Crown. That's almost it. There might be a few more small things that I want to get done, but that's my playbook for the next few episodes. I've also been doing research on enchantments and weapons and stuff. I don't know how effective crossbows are compared to bows. I don't know how effective silver is compared to mundane weapons. I don't know how Dawnguard weapons fit in there when it comes to undead. Do they only do bonus damage to vampires, or do they do bonus damage to all undead? I genuinely don't know. And the degree to which they do bonus damage, I also don't know. Apparently, the Dawnguard set reduces the damage you take from Vampire's Drain. Does that matter at all? Is that worth it? Because it looks kind of... it actually looked kind of good, but I know. See, that's the kind of things I'm thinking about. Like, min-maxing. I also, to a degree, wish I was a girl. Because then my Agent of the Bella perk, as in my War of the Sexes perk, would be a lot more potent, because most of my enemies are male. Right now I only do bonus melee damage against, melee and archer damage against women. Which is a bit, you know, uncomfortable in and of itself. But, Dwarven Hall, more of this stuff. Yeah, may as well. And carrying too much to be able to run. Fine. Miscellaneous. I'll drop the, actually, I could drop one of... I could drop two of these dragon scales. Because dragon scales are not actually all that valuable. You need dragon bones to make dragon bone arrows, not dragon scales. But, yeah. Alright, I guess I go home for a sec to drop my, not Castle Volgar. Not yet. It'll be a while before I do that. I'm gonna go home first, drop off these dragon bone toys. And after that, I suppose, head back for yet another quest from Sir Rain Girard. And Serana and the Armor Troll both still fine. Perfect. Mm-hmm. You've seen this before, a few times.
Good. Yes.
I've also been checking out, because, you know, I've had a little bit of downtime on the bus.
You smell like a wet
and,
dog.
You know, that's also a good reason to get rid of the... of the vampire trait, the werewolf trait, and change it out for a vampire one. You can still transform into a giant monster if you're a purebred vampire, which I'm aiming for, thanks to Serana's help. Well, being a vampire is awesome. You can live forever while still being a mortal, technically. Well, an immortal mortal, the best of both worlds. You're just really, really flammable, and technically you count as dead. But, hey, what can you do? You get what's given to you. Sorry, I'm a fan of, you know, the hives and that kind of music. Alright, Black Arrow Volume 2 goes in there, as are the Dragon Bones, books, miscellaneous. Oh yeah, I need to reforge these. Anything else I can just drop? No, not really. I'm gonna go with my bartering necklace. And apparently there's no speech enchantment. I did check that. Bartering enchantment is the best I can do. There might be something even better in the Thieves Guild, but that's all the way at the end of the Thieves Guild, which might be one of the last things I do. So we'll see. Definitely not something worth aiming for.
Hey,
especially
wanna
considering
play
just how rich I'm already.
Yes.
Yeah, enchantments are a variable thing. I've heard that there might be a bug where the Chaos Enchantment, which is an incredible thing, that has a 50% chance of doing like a Fire Enchantment's attack, 50% doing Frost Enchantment's attack, 50% chance of doing a Shock Enchantment's attack, and they all are independent, so you can do two or none or both or just one, you know, per attack. So that's a really powerful enchantment, and it gets powered up by every single one of the destruction things, like more shock spells damage, more frost spells damage, as well as the ones in the enchantment tree. The only downside is it's apparently bugged and only shock matters, and I'm not sure if that even works, if my current dual enchantment even does the same amount of fire and shock damage. Maybe it's just the shock damage that it does and only a little bit of fire damage, or the other way around. I still have yet to check that. When it comes right down to it, I'm gonna have to, like, either read up on it and be really sure of my sources, or more likely do some target practice, which is gonna be a lot of fun.
Seems there's no end to the needs. Looking to protect yourself, or deal some damage?
I'm not gonna bother asking him to get me outfitted. As well, I'm probably gonna grab some steel, some iron, some more calcium, because, you know, I'm near my house anyway, and I need to sell a few things. Apparel. Actually, I can sell one of these weird, ridiculously valuable iron daggers to him. Just the one. Yay. And am I still over-encumbered? No, I'm not. Good.
Anytime you need arms or armor.
So why was I even here? Because I might want to sell some... Yeah, why was I even here? Could have just went off to Serene Gerard. I suppose I could go back to
I'm a little busy at the moment.
To Angeline's aromatics and bits and pieces to sell some more stuff, I guess.
Yeah. Got something for just a... So you're interested in my potions and ingredients?
So yeah, the enchantments might be bugged, and I'm not sure what's better when it comes to just, you know, killing stuff. So I'm probably gonna have to because I really, really want to experiment with that at some point. I'm also inclined to go experiment with something along. Wait a minute. I could just sell her this one right now. Oh yeah, she got 1,300. I misjudged that. All right. Yeah. Sell her one of these. Boom. You got 143 gold left. You got a sapphire, which is worth a bit more than that. And what else? Mane of the Undead, which is also worth a bit more than that. Okay, I need to remember that so that I can just sell those.
Yes? What did you need?
I can talk to Octave Sound to get some more money for my buck.
Divine. Oh, thank you.
You can never have enough money
Divine
for my buck.
Bless your kind.
Actually, I could sell some at Radiant Raiment. I am considering making one of these ladies my wife.
Let me know if you see anything you like.
Yeah.
Why, hello. Here to buy. If you have to ask the price, you might be in the wrong store.
Oh, what delight.
What do you got for sale?
Breeches, gowns, clothes for any occasion, really.
Sapphire, and what was the other thing? Not a potion, piece of apparel? No, not a piece of apparel. Oh yeah, scroll. Bane of the Undead. Just, don't really have anything to... Bah. Okay.
Thank you. Finally.
Thank you. Let's go to bits and pieces. Sell that one. Scroll. Oh, it's Angeline's. This is bits and pieces. Sorry about the merchant thing. I didn't expect I would, but I suppose I could extend the episode a little bit.
What do you need? Some may call this.
I'll cut this out next time. Sorry.
I call them treasures.
What can I say? I'm a little bit absent-minded, and I'm not quite used to this. I wanted to, like, start cutting things out again, but, sometimes you just don't get down to it. Kinnereth. I don't have too many of those yet. Measure sneaking. I probably already have those. Okay, potions. No, weapons. One of them daggers. Not that dagger. This dagger. And apparently, the power of the enchantment doesn't affect how much, you level up from it, which is news to me. I always thought it did, but you live, you learn, I suppose. And again, that's just one source saying that, and not entirely certain myself. Alright, yeah, these are useless. Boom. Perfect, let's head back, home. Dump the rest of this stuff off. Yes, that is the thumb. That's the voice. Right, as for alchemy, there's a bunch of cool potions you can make. Some of the more powerful ones, like a serious case of paralysis along with a lingering damage health and damage health, which basically means paralysis, damage, and damage over time. That requires human flesh. As for a really powerful... damage health and like corrode health as well. That requires a secret ingredient that we haven't hit upon just yet, but we probably will in the next few episodes, or at least I'm planning to. But we will certainly run into that when we go look for the Dragon Elder Scroll. Those of you who've already been there probably know what it is. Yes, I'm starting to keep secrets from you because I'm so amused. Oh yeah, Dwarven Dwemer garbage. Darn it. I can just load from bits and pieces, I guess. Yeah. Coming out of bits and pieces, and I can just, you know, reforge the Dwarven Metal Stone. No, I can't, because this city doesn't have one of those. Fine, I'll go back home then. I'll carry them with me. This was entirely an exercise in pointlessness. Perfect. No, wait, I dropped the dragon bones off at home. Perfect. That works. I'm contemplating dressing that other mannequin up in Imperial armor, and then taking the Dawnguard armor off the other guy and making him a Stormcloak. I'm aware I've already done that one. Ah, well. Let's see. This is bleh. Common soul gem, dwarven metal ingots. Gee, why am I buying all this dwarven metal stuff? Maybe because I want to retrain my smithing. And if I get a... Wait a minute. If I can calculate this right, the warrior stone is 20%. I can get 30% from my wife and abuse of the lover stone in combination with the... Ethereum circlet, the Ethereum crown, that's it. So that's 50% extra XP, and I can get 15% more extra XP from Avanchenzel in the West. Apparently there's a quest that does something that gives you 15% extra XP, which apparently is also an ordeal which involves ghosts. Yes, I'm starting to keep secrets from you now. So I'm gonna go do that before I go level my smithing back up, and I can probably do it a third, fourth, fifth time if I really want all the perks, but I'm probably not gonna do that too often because that'll probably mess with my overall level as compared to my enemy's level. Yeah. Then again, I did just take a dragon down with fire spell, so I seem to be becoming a master of all. Then again, that's only direct combat. But I'm pretty good at illusion as well.
Good to have you by my side.
Ooh, look at the sky. It's gorgeous. Why am I here? Oh, yeah. Because I want to forge some things. I am definitely paying attention, I'm honest. I'm not completely spent from this day's work and not just doing this because I really love it. That's honestly not what's going on at all. What makes you think that? Okay, the few dwarven metal ingots, they don't actually increase my weight that much. Just a little bit, you know. Who am I kidding? 297 weight is still quite a bit. What am I even carrying with me? Oh, iron ingots. A bunch of iron ingots. Let's head back home, then. And only then can we go back to Serene Gerard. I'll make this an extra long episode. Sorry. I mean, I could cut this out, but... I could just as well run through and... I did exposition about all the things I've researched, and I've yet to research. I'm actually really interested in finding out what's better, an enhanced dwarven crossbow, or a dragon bone bow, or a Stalrim bow, because it has the power to fortify frost enchantments and chaos enchantments by an additional 25%. And like I explained before, those stack with each other. So I'm not sure what's going to be better. Same thing with daggers. What's going to be better, a dragon bone dagger? Or a, a dragonbone dagger, or a dagger that is, made of Stalrim with an enchantment. Because, you know, you do 15 times extra damage on backstab, so it's probably going to be the dragonbone one. But, the fact that you can add ludicrous amounts of extra, damage on top, in the form of enchantments, might be useful as well, but it won't differ too much, but it could go either way. I mean, the extra enchantment damage might tip the scales, and the extra... That's one of the minutiae kind of things, those small, small interesting things that I'm really curious about. And no, you can't melt down Dwemer Lovers somehow. Maybe you need two of them. I don't know. Alright, we're done here. Time to finally head out. Right? Right. 250 weight is fine by me. I'll sort the rest of it out some other time. But doing experiments with that kind of stuff, probably without backstabbing, actually, because if you do backstab, you get a 15 times damage multiplier. I might need to try that out once or twice, but I'm not sure if anything will survive that. Right, back to Serene Gerard and ask if she has yet another quest for us, because I want to unlock, like I said, the enhanced dwarven crossbow, as well as all the explosive dwarven bolts before I go become a vampire, because she won't like it very much, nor will Isran. If I become a vamp... Did I even train with the... Have I even trained yet? I can check. Because she can train me how to be a better marksman, so if I haven't trained yet, I should do that post-haste. I think I have, though.
Hope you get... I like what Isran has done with the place.
Can you train me to be a better marksman?
I can certainly try.
Yeah, 5-5, so... I'm back from Rubber's Gorge with the Dormer Exploding Ice Bolt.
Let's see what you've got there. I see. Similar to the Exploding Bolt, only this one will cause damage with splintering shards of ice sharp as glass. Charming.
Hmm.
Here, let me show you how this works.
Okay.
I'll have some for sale soon.
Alright. What can I do to help?
It's amazing what I'm able to learn from studying these Dwemer plants.
Shock bolts?
Wanna Dwemer head out exploding there shock bolts. Some more?
Shuanzo. I think I already need to go there. Sure. What am I? Shuanzo. Wait a minute. Shuanzo. What isn't Shu? Wait a minute, that's inside Markarth! Cool! I completely forgot about that. There's some quests in there as well. To kill Nimmy, the spider, as well as some other stuff. Peril. The Circle of Peril is destruction. I need to get rid of that, so. Mask of Cloud, this extortion vial. And what do you got for sale?
I'll buy whatever you're looking to get rid of.
Miscellaneous. I'm willing to buy some Grand Soul Gems. Greater Soul Gem, Lesser Soul Gem, Petty Soul Gem. Ebony? Nah, I got plenty of ebony by this point. I'm willing to buy those lockpicks, though. And yeah, you have some exploding steel bolts, but I want some exploding dwarven bolts. So instead, I'll just sell you one of these iron daggers and we'll call it even. Just one. I don't want to break her bank. There we go. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Oops, I forgot. Well, I'll just talk to what's his face. He's probably got some stuff to sell as well. Yeah, you do, don't you? No, Gunmer. Flinchers. Yeah, okay.
Arkay's been watching over me for years now.
What do you have to sell?
Well, some things, I suppose. Remedies, cures,
Circlet of Peerless,
poison or two,
and destruction. 800. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna have to talk to him about that.
Cozy little. Keep yourself armed and protected as best you can.
Circlet of Peerless destruction, and you might know you won't be able to do that. Okay. If I grabbed some dwarven metal off you, not all of it, just a little bit. You'd probably be able to purchase a sapphire, right? I've already sold that. Well, whatever. So be it. Let's purchase the rest of it. This ebony and this gold iron as well. And this iron. I do not know when to quit. No. 2098. I'm willing to just go with 1600. Boom.
Take care of yourself.
Hey, Serana, could you carry this for me for a sec?
What did you need?
What are you doing? That's so dangerous.
This better not be all the things you just can't be bothered with.
No comment. Some dwarven metal, some ebony, not gonna bother with the soul gems or the iron ore, but the rest of it, yeah, you can keep that for a sec. Okay, good. I'm stocking up for the winter. Apparel, destruction. Little helmets, and let's get out of here. Chuanzel. There's other quests I need to do there. Journal. Miscellaneous. Yeah. Miscellaneous. Kill Nimmy inside in Chuanzel. Is there another one? I think that's all of it. Yeah, sure. I also should have talked to Bryling while I was in solitude, but I didn't. Eh, well. On a Markarth, of all places. And that place has seen a vampire attack before. So I might want to lay over at the Reachwater Rock and try and make sure it's daytime. Yes. Standor is a god of righteous rule by might and merciful forbearance. Indeed. Okay, that'll be fine. Let's go straight to Understone Keep. Right. And then, well,
what do you need, Bard?
Oh yeah, no. Bard. Nimmy. Well, a bunch of dwarven spiders. I think this might be the first time where we will face Falmer. That's gonna be fun. It's not. And the best part is, I'm not a vampire, so I'm not immune to poison. The Falmer like their poison quite a bit. Chuanzo, would have guessed. Well, this would be a place where dwarven stuff's kept. I've never actually done this, I think. This doesn't really look familiar. If I have done this, I have completely forgotten. Even now. Well, this looks to be fairly one way. Problem is, the freaking Dwemer are resistant to anything that isn't just... That's not the one, it's just a spider. Oh yeah, I won't just be fighting Dwemer robots, I'll be fighting spiders and stuff. And stuff. Okay, actually, magic. Conjuration. Raise zombie. Yes! Just for fun. I got a frostbite spider now. That's all good. Oh, this is... Oh, that's... Hello, Shelob. Tell Kosumi the Nimi is dead. No, no, we're gonna keep going. The hell? Solonia, we've been saddled with some researchers who can't go four steps without examining something, and they fight about as well as you'd think. Probably worse. Strom at least has some magical confidence, but none of them can swing a sword. Urgent cracks, he moved to something, so lots of keep an eye on them. But stop and assume me, they're trustworthy. Okay, so a ragtag bunch of. Okay, Lost Expedition. The Lost Expedition. Retrieve Strom's journal. So his journal, and not his person. That's... Well, that's, foregone conclusion, I suppose. What's gonna happen now? I'm guessing... Yep, my very first Falmer ever.
Who's there?
Lesson one, they crouch. Lesson two, they got Falmer ears on them because they're Falmer. Ooh! Cool. I'm not gonna take your stuff. It's heavy and not exactly all that valuable. No, 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 well. Also, fun fact, invisibility doesn't work on them, they're blind, but muffle works all the better. Oh, God. And Shuan's all quarters. There's something here.
Who's there?
Oh. Goodbye. More dwarven metal stuff. I've got one. Local map. That's my destination, so I need to go back there. Right? No. No, not there. I need to go down here. What? Oh, at least I'm going the right way, I think. It is however extremely unwinding force sounds like the right thing to try. They're dead. Okay, Strom is dead as well. I've decided to remain behind one of our guards and further document the living area we stumbled across. Disappearance of Dwemer, anything as a tree, cannot determine the purpose of a tree, area around Whiterun, why not? I've got here is beyond me. Gift from the surface world, surrounding display of power. Collapse itself, Falmer began to creep back in this area of the ruins. Falmer began to creep back indeed. More journals, great. Prince Dobbin's journal. Old void salts. Void salts. There's nothing much else here, I think. I didn't think we need to go back there. Or back there. I don't know. Let's just look at this place all the way around. Ooh, that's not very pleasant, is it? All have you been doing? Torturing people is what he's been doing. It's a dead guard. That's where he went. Okay, that's this place looked at. Cool. Little tree. It's weird where that's there, but doesn't matter. Okay. Where do we go now? Back up, I guess, and forward. Can we go over there? Can we possibly go over there? I don't know. Let's check it out. Probably not, actually. Trolls still give me the creeps. Yes, we can go in there. We can! Alrighty. Oh, Fulmer.
Knew I heard something.
Seriously, a skeever? Suppose the Falmer can have pets too. Dwemer dresser, a fork. Perfect. At least they're civilized beings, these Dwemer. Not gonna bother with the Dwemer metal. It can be melted down, but I don't care. Zombie Dwemer for Serana. Where do we go now? Oh, yeah, we go back. We also, at the end of this dungeon, there's probably the ice bolt thing. Shock bolt, sorry. More than shock bolts. Which apparently are made with void salts, which is appropriate because we found it. At least I got very close to 90 destruction at this point. Yeah. That's a lot of powerful falling. That was a lot of powerful falling. That was just one. It's probably not that powerful. Former ear. Gold. Former ear gold. Two Falmer rares, now that's more like it. Whoops, Falmer sword. All their stuff's made from Chara's kitten, which is a organic plastic, essentially, kitten, like the hair. And, Chara's are monstrous things. Bugs. They've grown very symbiotic relationships with Falmer. Everything with Falmer. Charge. 90 destruction already. And I leveled up as well. Cool. I should, after this, definitely get some more training. And alteration, I guess, yeah. Sorcery Perch. Let's level up. So we got a bunch of spare perks. That is not going to change. Going to put 300 points in the Magicka, and then I think level stamina up to at least 250. Yeah, sounds good. This is then the side entrance. Alright, let's keep going. There is nothing here. Oh, a flawless sapphire. That's not exactly nothing. Troll still scares me. Alright, let's keep going. Okay, so that's where I went and rampaged around. There doesn't seem to be a way off this rock. So I'm guessing the point is to jump down. Alright, where do we need to go? Oh yeah, of course.
What did you need?
It says to go back. Well, what if I change it to going here? Chuan's old armory. Hello. And there was one behind me. They have a lot of toys on them. A lot of toys. What's down here? That is not a challenge. Yay. Well, Urge's notes. How foolish to move through this place so quickly. It's taken me only a few hours to crack the back gate. Maybe I'll donate a cup or two, but Crack says he knows some private buyers will buy handsomely for a working trinket. There has to be one in here. Side doors are all locked, but this chest should have one or two things of value. When I get out, I'm going to buy myself a castle. No. I think the robots activated. And if they didn't, I'm very surprised. What happens if I open this chest? The robots are gonna turn on, aren't they? Oh, Ruby. That's powerful, but I'm not gonna buy it. Yep, robots. Not those robots. You're a non-threat. Okay, that's that dealt with. Let's find some more. Think there's any others in the armory? No, there aren't. Enemy is dead. The exits, this is where we need to be. Okay. How about we go this way then? Just follow the bouncing ball, I guess. Whoa, what the hell? Oh, void salts. Yeah, those are very valuable. And that was a trapdoor. And that's back the way we came. Okay, good. Excuse me. Okay, that robot looks like it can come alive. That looks like one of the researchers. What's this? Sithis. Hello. And cracked journal. I knew if we dug deep enough, we'd eventually hit some fresh ruins. Mark Earth, a city built upon a city Nunchuanzel. Don't see proper sign of the chair. Ruins just in case. If anyone could open the lock, it's him. We keep going until it opens. Yeah, okay, so Urge has been left behind anyway, so this is further ahead chronologically. And that thing's alive, come on. Oh, well, darn. Oh, that's one of ours. Right. Okay, where's the other ones? Recovery of the Tormer, Shock Bolts, and Staubin Journal. That's the last one. It's pretty obvious that the Falmer have made quite a mess.
Who's there?
Yeah. Archery might be a little bit quicker, not entirely certain. Staubin's diary. After making our way down the mine to the spiders, we fed them in a dungeon jungle proper. Built the city in a very capable hazard. It hums with life, gardens lay dormant. Families lived. Studying the tree. Cannot figure out what significance is. So it's just a decorative tree, the way modern people have, you know, potted trees, you know. But they don't understand it because they're primitives. They will, maybe, maybe not, I don't know. Farmer gets to break into the best of his own locks. Vaults. Spiders. Only thing keeping Margaret. Wait, whoa, what? Whoa, whoa, whoa. The spiders gave us much trouble, but who could have foreseen they've been keeping the only thing keeping Margaret safe? Of course, the spiders have been blocking up the entrance so the Falmer couldn't get in. After exiting the armory, we made camp, but the Falmer have been watching us and finally tired of our intrusion. They came while we slept and slaughtered what guards were left. Meridia, forgive me for using my students as a distraction to get away, but I have to bring this place back to life. Too many. Couldn't hit switch. Okay, so... Whoa, bring this back to life. He wants to reboot the Dwarven systems to clean out the Falmer. I'm actually okay with that plan. I like that plan. It's an audacious plan. It's a suicidal plan. It's perfect. Summer cock. Yeah, oh god, more. No, 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 die. It's a gyro. Don't care about the gyro. Don't care about the gyro. Oh, that's a sphere. Not actually significantly damaging me. Oh, that was tough. Very tough. These things are actually pretty resistant to all magic, did you know? Well, now you do. And Mr. Troll's just straggling along, playing bait. Oh, a few dead Falmer. Oh, human flesh. Yeah, that's quite a powerful little poison. Also very rare. Let me guess, this boots up the when we pull this lever, all hell will break loose. Alright, Dwarmer exploding shock bolts, that's all we wanted. Gold, syringe Gerard, and activate lever.
Yes. What did you need?
Someone who knows about the expedition. I've already recovered Staubing's journal, right? Seems I haven't. Weird. So, recover Staubing's journal. Yeah, I'm sure that Calselmo knows. Alright, so how the hell do we even get out of here? Do we just exit? Run? I guess. I'd go invisible, but with, what's her name near me? I can't really afford to do that. Let's see what kind of hell is broken loose here. Oh yeah, look at that. Yep.
Who's there?
Nope. Don't bother. Of course she's gonna bother. Okay, I'm gonna run. I'm just gonna hightail it out of here. Tomer robots are all nice and good, but let's get the heck out of here.
Where'd you come from?
Oh. Nothing. Okay. Oh. She resurrected Nimby. That's cool. What's this? Huh. Well, whatever it might have been is gone now. Or at least after images, ghosts from running away. But that was a lot of Falmer and a lot of Dwemer. Didn't want to bother. Got plenty of their stuff anyway right now. Okay, exit. Oops. It's not quite what I wanted to do, but we got the stuff for gonna chew on Zell. And yeah, once we've talked to Calselmo, I'm probably gonna end the episode unless something weird happens.
The artifacts I've discovered in Nishuan Zell will make history one day.
Killed Nimmy.
You have my gratitude. That spider had been interfering with my excavations for months.
Yeah,
as
about
promised,
that.
Use the key to the Dwemer Museum. Mind the displays. Some of them are quite fragile.
I have found this expedition journal.
Let's see. Ah, so that's what happened to Stavin. Tragic. But I warned him he was leading those people on a fool's errand. Unfortunately, sometimes the stone of scholarship is built on the foundation of death. I'll inform the kin.
So he died a dumbass's death.
I usually pay researchers for their work when they emerge from the ruins, but they won't be needing it anymore.
Mm. All right. I'd like to make an investment in your business.
Excellent. I think you'll be glad that you made.
Here you go.
Thank you. I'll be sure to.
Right. Apparel. Clive's vial, etc., etc. See you guys back at Fort Dawnguard. Yeah.